So topic is HTML form. If you have noticed, for example, I am going through online admission process, okay? So I have to provide information to your to portal that I have got this percentage in this subject, okay? So how do you provide this information? So you provide this information using form, okay? So there has to be a form in your HTML, in your web page, okay, to take input from your user. For example, this is a simplest kind of form, okay? Over here you can see that it is this text kind of, it can be password type value, in some form there is a drop down list, it can be a checkbox also, radio button, and after that there is a submit button, okay? So by clicking on that, you will submit your data finally, okay? This is very important because if you create any kind of web application, you will need this. You will need to implement form, okay? So let's just check it out. Now form, it is just another kind of HTML tag, okay? Now to create a form, name itself is form tag, okay? In angular brackets, form. HTML forms are used to create GUIs on web page. That means UI, that means graphical user interface. That means I want enter your name, okay? So after that there will be a text box and I have to just provide my name like this. Usually purpose is to ask the user for information, and this information is then sent back to the server. A form is an area that can contain form element, okay? So syntax for creating form is like this. Form, this is your form, and inside form there are some parameters, and after in this pair of this form tag there are certain form elements, okay? These form elements, it can be button, checkbox, text field, radio buttons, drop down menus, okay? And this HTML tag, it can be mixed with other form element also. A form usually contains a submit button to send the information in the form elements to the server. Now, whatever I have entered in my form, okay, it has to be submit to the server, okay? So that's why we need a submit button. Or there is also another kind of button that is clear, that means reset, okay? Whatever you have entered it, you just click on reset button and all information will be gone, okay? So this is also one kind of button. This is submit and the clear or reset. Now a form's parameter, okay, over here in form's syntax you can see that in this opening form tag I have to maintain some parameter, okay? I have to set some parameter. Now this parameter will tell browser how to send the information to the server, okay? There are two different ways to send this information to server. Now form tag there are certain arguments and parameter includes it is form element, okay? Now argument to form tell what to do with the user input. For example, there is one argument that is action, okay? Now whenever I click on submit button, it has to be processed somewhere, okay? For example, I am providing my bio data, so this bio data has to be stored somewhere in some database over server, okay? So I have to mention where this information should be stored, what is next place to be processed this data, okay? So this is a parameter, or I can say argument, to specify this. Now URL specify where to send the data when submit button is clicked, whenever I hit the submit button, okay? So whatever it is, it will pass to this URL. Now another argument is method, okay? How will I send my form data? This is it can be set into method. That means it can be either get or it can be either post method. If you don't mention any method, if you don't mention any method argument, then it will get default value, that is get method. Okay. Form data info appended to the end, okay, and it can be used only if data is all ASCII, not more than 100 characters. Now it is in my introduction section you will get difference between what is difference between get and post post method. Just watch it out, okay, for further information related to get and post. Okay, let me just give you one point about it. Whenever you use get method, all the fields it will be displayed on your address bar, okay, HTTP something something something, like that, name is equals to this, password is equals to this, like this. But if you use method is equals to post, that means your all the information will be not provided in your address bar. Second thing about this method is you cannot bookmark bookmark that form, okay, of web page that contained a form with method post. You cannot bookmark this. Whenever you are whenever you are providing some credential related information, for example my account number, okay, my CVV numbers, whenever you are purchasing something online shopping, okay, so you should use over there post method, not get. Now third argument is target. Now this this parameter will tell you where to open the page sent as a result of the as a result of request. For example, I have just hit the submit button, okay, my data is saved. Now after submitting I will get some acknowledgement that my that my data is stored successfully and I supposed to be somewhere in my web page, okay. So this parameter will tell you if you your target is set as a underscore blank, that means your new window will be opened, okay, and if your target is equals to underscore top, that means it will use the same window. For example, I am this is my web page, okay, and I am just hit on submit button. So if it is target is equals to blank, that means another new window will be opened and I will get some acknowledgement over there, or I will get a final web document where I should be, okay. And if target is equals to top, that means process will be continued in same window. Now image tag text field input tag text field, okay, it is provided to text field. For example, I have just mentioned text messages, enter your name, okay. So after this label there has to be some text field where I can provide my input, okay. So for this purpose you can use input tag like this, okay. So input tag and type is equals to text, name is equals to input name. Over here input it can have two attribute, more than two attribute, type, name, ID, class, these are the attributes of input tag, okay. So type and name and ID, these three are most important. So type is equals to tag and name is equals to input name. So I just write name, enter name, name is Darshan, okay, like this. After that, password field. There are certain situations you are going to enter your password. For example, enter your password and you just entered your password. So over there, if you mention type is equals to tag, then your password will be exposed. Okay. So over in that case, you have to set type is equals to password so that it will be syntax will be like this. After that, radio button. Whenever you have to select only one choice among given choice, then you have to use type is equals to radio, okay. Now over here you can in all that elements I am using input tag only, but type is different. Over here type is text, type is password, type is radio, okay. So this is example of radio. For example, a candidate is male or female. A candidate is another example is candidate is male or female. Another example is married or unmarried. Okay, like this. So this is the cases where you can use radio button. Now checkbox over here, type as a tag, and type is equals to tag checkbox. Name is equals to roll number 1, 2, and 3. Okay, over here when type is equals to checkbox, that means you can select multiple items at a time. Okay, it is not like the radio button. Only in radio button you can select only one item, but okay, but in checkbox you can select multiple items. Now after that, drop down list. Now in drop down list, select tag is used to create drop down. Okay, now to insert item into your drop down list, there is option tag. Okay, and it is used inside the select tag. For example, like this, select to create drop down list. If you just write it down like it is now, that means you have created drop down list. Now to insert item into the drop down list, like this, you have to write it down option, or you have to write it as many times as there is a numbers of entries in the in your drop down list. For example, I have 3 entries, Rajkot, Ahmedabad and Surat. That means I have to create 3 option tag, okay, in pair, and its value is different. Okay, so this is a select drop down list like this. Now if you are using this kind, that means you can select only one item at a time, but if you want to select multiple, then you just have to set one attribute of select tag, that is set multiple is equals to multiple. Okay, that means you can select multiple multiple values in your drop down list. Now after that, text area. Okay, text area, it define a multi-line text input control. How can you define text area in your web form? So this is text area tag, opening and closing. Now there is two attribute of this tag, rows and calls. Rows, it will define what numbers of rows it will get in your text area, and calls will define number of I can say width of your text area, and rows, it is identical to height of your text area. Okay, like this. After that, submit button. A submit button is used to submit the data to the form. To the form action URL, just I have said that there is one parameter, that is action, where to proceed this data. Okay, so there has to be some medium to so that I can hit that action. Okay, so there is a submit button, and type is equals to submit over here. You can see input type is equals to submit, and value is add city. Okay, so this is your submit button. So this is all about in HTML form. This is just a theoretical section. I will upload one video in which I will in text editor I will show how to create HTML form. Wait for that session.